Are you a big Kasabian fan, and if so, why?
Yeah, of course, big Kasabian fan, because I think, about 10 years ago, there was this sort of idea that they were the natural successors to Oasis, and then when Noel Gallagher kind of gave them his blessing, it was set in stone. But no, I think they're great musicians, they're great lads. I've played football with Serge plenty of times, had a couple of drinks with him. So yeah, it's great to be here. I think they're brilliant.
What's the new album, Riding High, at number one at the moment? Have you heard it, and what did you make of it?
Yeah, I thought it was fantastic. It's a real departure for them sound-wise as well. So I think it's always brave for a band of that size to just kind of want to keep themselves entertained and keep themselves fresh, and then try and move along and reinvent themselves. So yeah, I mean, I loved it. And if it's at number one, obviously, I wasn't the only one.
What have you got coming up yourself at the moment? We love seeing you. Where are we going to see you next?
I've just finished filming a BBC One period drama called Our Zoo, which I don't know yet, but I think it's scheduled for release in September. So I'll be playing Billy. Billy? I've forgotten his second name. That's terrible. I'll be playing Billy in Our Zoo in September on BBC One.
What's that all about?
It's about the founding. It's a true story about the founding of Chester Zoo. It's sort of... the same period of time as kind of Call the Midwife, Downton, that kind of feel, that kind of period. And it's about a guy who came home from the trenches traumatised and set up a zoo that's now the biggest zoo in Europe.
Why do you think period drama continues to fascinate so much? What's our fixation as a nation, particularly with that time period?
That's a good question. And I've got to think of a sensible, intelligent-sounding answer. I wonder if people's obsession with that period, it's something that people feel that they can really attach a sense of Britishness to, because everyone talks about old Britishness now, but times are changing. You know, the shape of the country is always changing. So I think that people feel very secure looking at that period and thinking that's what it means to be British, which of course almost 100 years ago, so it's not what it means to be British anymore, but I think it makes people feel very comfortable about who they are.
Are there any other familiar faces we're going to recognise in that cast?
Peter White, Liz White, Lee Ingleby, who's fantastic, is playing the lead. It's a real cast of character actors that, I've seen the first episode and I don't know, I think it deserves people to enjoy it. I hope people will like it.
What else have you got on the horizon? Is there anything else you're going on to after that?
I'm about to do a couple of episodes of a new Channel 4 crime drama, a gritty police crime drama, in which I play a petty criminal who grew up with the main policeman, which is nice for me because it's not normally the kind of thing I get to do. And it's a bit dark, it's gritty, Channel 4 police drama, and London as well, so I can dust off my best Dick Van Dyke accent and see how we get on.
Is that a conscious decision at the moment? It seems like you're kind of all over the place. Are you trying to sort of spread yourself a little bit and kind of show your range?
Well, you know what? I'm older. I'm 34 years old. I'm not 17-year-old Anthony from the Royle Family anymore. And I think you kind of, what we were talking about with Kasabian before, you either reinvent yourself and keep on changing and being interesting, or you wither away and fade into nothingness career-wise. That was a bit bleak. But so yeah, it's really nice to do different things. It's really nice. I've never done period drama before. I've never done gritty police drama before. So it's keeping me busy.
Do you have another project in the works, I think, with Rupert Grint? Are you doing something with him?
Yes, I've got a beautiful animation. Animate style-wise, it's... what's it like? It's in the sort of Shrek, Toy Story, How to Train Your Dragon kind of mould, Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs kind of mould of animation. And it was originally made in Argentina, and it's been revoiced over here. It's called The Unbeatables, and it's about... I play a table football... the captain of a table football team who comes to life to help out my best mate.
Obviously, football's very much in our minds at the moment. Did you enjoy the World Cup such as it was?
Absolutely loved the World Cup. Completely loved it. To the point where when England went out, I was gutted for about half a day, and then I went, still the best World Cup ever. I'm just going to carry on watching. Bit gutted that Messi didn't win, though.
You mentioned the Royle Family earlier on. It still remains very much in the hearts of the nation. Why do you think that series had such a particular impact and garnered such affection from people?
I think when it came out, it was completely new. I don't think anyone had seen anything like it before. And I think, as well as being very funny, it's all about familiarity. Everybody, even whatever class, social status you are, everyone has a family, and I think everybody recognised parts of their own family in it. And you know, we've all done it. We've all gone, oh, you won't believe what my mum said, you won't believe what my dad's like. Well, they just managed to condense all that and put it into half-hour real-time slots, and that's the genius of Caroline and Craig. That's what they did so well. I owe everything to it, and if Caroline and Craig ever said to me, do you want to do it, then I almost don't feel it would be my position to not support them in whatever they wanted to do, because I owe my entire career to them. But I think people still love it. I think as long as they can keep on writing good scripts, I think there's a place for it. I mean, I'd always like more, because it's great fun to do. You know, it's like the old gang gets back together. It is like a whole family getting back together and making each other laugh. So it'd be great fun, but at the moment, no plans.
Got a message for fans before you leave us?
Fans of what? Football, the World Cup, the Royle Family, or Kasabian?
You, I guess.
Oh, I don't think I have any fans, but if I do, thanks. That's my only message.
After period drama, that might win people.
Yeah, exactly, that'll all change, yeah.